What's up, you guys? What's up, divas? What's up, divos? It's your girl, and we back for the Real Talk video. It's Wednesday, you guys, and I'm going to relax today. I hope you guys are having, like, an amazing day. It is Wednesday. It's the middle of the week from some people, and for me, it's just a regular day, you know. I basically work, like, every day out of the week, but today's video is just Real Talk. I'm going to do some crafts after this. I have been doing quite a few crafts, because I did redecorate my upstairs hallway. I think that's what you would want to call it, because it's kind of like a hallway. So I got rid of some really old things. They were old because I did travel here with them from New York, which was back in 2014. And I had them probably like 6-7 years before I moved here. So I decided to get rid of those things because, first of all, they were my things, but they weren't bought by me in particular. And so sometimes when you want to get, you know, out with the old, in with the new, sometimes you even have to get rid of materialistic things. So these dressers or tables, whatever that I had upstairs, I did get rid of them. I didn't really want any reminders of a past relationship. So out with the old, in with the new, not saying that there's a new relationship, but you know, some things you just got to get rid of, because when you're through, you're through. When you're done, you're done. And that is what I've done lately a lot. I have gotten rid of a lot of memorabilia that, excuse me, was dear to me, close to my heart at a particular time. And though I should have gotten rid of those things before I moved here, I still had, you know, held those items close to me. But, you know, after a while, you get fed up with certain things and you just have to get rid of the old. So out with the old, in with the new. And I did redecorate my upstairs hallway. And I was looking for a particular size table and I went to the furniture store. They were running over $200. And for a small table that I was looking for, I was not trying to pay $200, especially if I know that to me, that size is not worth it. And my daughter, Nay, was like, don't you use what you have? And she made a really valid point. I have so many things that I could redo, repurpose. And you guys know I love the Dollar Tree and I love the thrift store. So on Mondays, thrift store is everything half off. And I have purchased a nice stand and picture frames. And you know what? I did the whole upstairs with the things that I had. The only thing that I had to purchase was a plant, which was not even much. So I did that. And that's what my week has been. So lately I have been just redoing things in my home. And Sunday and today is Tuesday, but today is really Tuesday when I'm recording this. So Sunday and Tuesday was wash day. I washed my hair on Sunday and I liked the look of it. So I rewashed it this morning when I took a shower. And this is all me. This is my natural hair texture. It's curly. You know, the shrinkage is real, but my hair falls about the shoulder length. That's it. It's not as long as it used to be. It used to be like past my back, in the middle of my back, but I did cut it over time and it's not as thick as it used to be. It's not as full as it used to be. So I've been wearing it like this for the past 3 days. And I don't know, you guys, it's kind of hard to manage like this. Like, I went to sleep and I put it in a pineapple. And then when I woke up, I put some stuff on it. So I'm not really knowing what to do with it too much with it like this. And sometimes I don't really like it like this because I just feel like I want to say it kind of makes me look older. I don't know if that's the look I'm going for. So I washed it today because I did have plans on, you know, throwing it in some cornrows and doing a couple of wig videos. But then I said, I don't feel like it today, so I'll do the wig videos tomorrow, because I just really like to just do Real Talk on Tuesday so that way I can get it edited and up for Wednesday. So that's it for today. So other than that, I hope you guys are having a great day. Once again, about that gel polish that I did mention, I did get my nails redone. Gosh, it's been probably like 10 days. The gel polish from Nail Addict, which is $20 a pop, a bottle, but there's a 55% coupon off on my channel. I wouldn't even use the coupon for it because after 2 days, it started chipping the nail polish. And this is the second time that I've used their nail polish. The first time was with the red. Now the thumb looks like this. So it's half naked and the index finger is chipping too. So as much as I really like this color, I will be going to get it removed and I'll I have three other bottles left that I haven't tried out of theirs. I'm not even going to bother because I'm not going to keep going back. My nails haven't even outgrown, but the reason why I have to go back is because the polish. And yeah, I'm not going to use it. So my opinions on Nail Addict is don't even bother. So yeah, you guys, also, if you have any type of advice on how to keep your curl pattern looking refreshed and moisturized, because I have so many products, I'm not really sure what to use because I've never really worn my own natural hair out curly like this. Even though my curl pattern it wasn't that great about a year ago. And I started using this stuff a couple months ago that was sent to me. And girl, it got my curls popping like they are even better than before. Okay. So I don't know what to tell you guys, but I would like to wear it more like this. However, I am going to get it cut really short. So I will be wearing it short and curly. So if you guys have any ideas or any advice on how to keep your curls refreshed without having to wash your hair daily, please let me know because, you know, I only deal with wigs. And, you know, you could wear a wig and then wash it and it'll be dry at night. You don't want to wash your hair and run out the door. Not always, especially in the wintertime. So anyway, so let's get into this real talk. You guys, if you have a real talk, need a real talk, need some advice, some opinions, then you can always send me an email to aprilsrealtalk@gmail.com. I will post that email down below in the description box. You can also put in the subject real talk, and you can also mention that you want to change your name, or you can say you can call me Sally Mae. If you don't tell me what to call you, I'm definitely going to make up a name for you. But just keep in mind, this is my opinions. I'm not a, you know, licensed Dr. Phil or anything. This is just my opinions of life itself, of the things that I've been through, or just life, you know what I'm saying? So, and not just my opinions, but also my lady subscribers and my men subscribers here's opinions too, because it's not just about me, it's about them too, because I'm pretty sure everyone has experienced stuff. So instead of me rambling on, let's just get into this. So, how do you even deal with this? Okay. Hi, April. Thank you for restarting your Real Talk videos because I've been watching all the old ones like reruns, LOL. I have been coping with some things that I really could use some input on from everyone. Does size really matter to people? I mean, as in weight size. So she's talking about in weight size. You can call me Sylvia for the video. I'm a bigger woman. My pants size is an 18 and I am 5'6" tall. I do have a little fupa stomach and hips and butt. All the women I hang with are smaller than me, and it seems like they are always in a relationship with someone and happy as ever. But for me, I remain single and seem to get no play. I'm always put together, never sloppy, and always wear things that fit. But I just feel like my weight is stopping me from finding a man. When I go shopping with them, meaning for clothes shopping at the mall with my friends, some of the stores they like to shop at don't always cater to my size. And honestly, it makes me feel left out or awkward. Not to mention, even when I'm out alone, I always see couples. And most of the time, these women are always smaller than me. And they're always with men. I've gotten to the point where I don't even like to go on social media and scroll because I see all these small women modeling things or being in a relationship. And I've gotten to the point where maybe I need to perfect my body with surgery to enhance myself in order to find love and happiness. I don't know what to think at this point. Is this a true fact that today's society needs to be a certain size to be happy in life and find joy and love? I want to be happy. I just want to find someone to love me and be happy with. How does a person cope with being overweight and happy with themselves? Please, any advice will be well taken. I just want to know, is it me who gets tired of seeing this? Sylvia. Okay. So, you know something? This is a really good topic. This is, like, all of them are good topics, but, you know, I feel her and I could relate to how she's feeling, you know what I'm saying? So, Sylvia is better yet. She's a size, pants size 18. She's 5'6", and most of all of her friends that she hangs out with are smaller women. So when she's out with them, they get in play, they're in relationships, you know, men are trying to talk to them. When they go shopping, most of the stores that Sylvia shops at with them don't cater to her size. And she's starting to feel left out, awkward, and she's wondering if she just gets surgery to enhance herself, then she's going to find joy and happiness and love. First of all, let me tell you this, Sylvia. And it's not just me telling you this, but I've said this to myself and I've said this to my daughter, Mumsy, also, because Mumsy is 13. She'll be 14 in August and Mumsy's tall. She's like 5'7 or 5'8. Mumsy is 5'8, okay? And I'm 5'5. So Mumsy's tall, all right? But she used to always feel some type of way also about her weight. And she would say things, not even just about her weight, but about her hair texture too. You know, she has like a 4C, 4B or 4C hair texture. And so does my daughter, Nay. But Mumsy would always say how she wants her hair to look like this girl's and that girl's. And the pictures that I would see were not girls of, you know, of our ethnic group, but would be of a different race. And I would have to explain to her, not even just about the hair texture, but about the weight. Everybody is unique in their own size. Like, God didn't make us into clones. He made every last person unique. We come in all different shapes and sizes. That's why there's all different sizes for clothing in the store. And it is unfortunate. I know how she feel when she say, well, I go to certain stores and they don't cater to my size. Trust me, girl. I know how you feel. That's like yesterday, me and Nay and Mumsy, we went to Arizona Mills Mall. And I like that mall. But there are a lot of stores in there that don't really cater to my size, along with my daughter Mumsy's size. But for my daughter Nay, of course they do. But these little boutiques, I don't really, you know, I can more or less judge them like a grain of salt. It's either here nor there. Because what comes in that small size in this store, I'm pretty sure I could find somewhere else in my size. It may be a little bit classier. But I understand how she feels. Now, me personally, I don't really have a lot of friends. So I can't say, well, when I went out with this one or that one. You know what I mean? But I get what she's saying about scrolling on social media. It does get a little bit irritating after a while. And then sometimes I used to feel like that too. But then I started feeling like, you know something? When it was time for me to lose the weight that I lost, in the beginning, I did do it for one particular reason, and that was to look good for somebody else. That was my first reason. But then I started feeling like, you know what, I'm gonna do this for me. And I'm not doing it to look like this girl on social media or that girl. I'm gonna do it because I wanna be healthy, and that's it. And that's why I did lose the weight. I did it because my knees were hurting bad, and I just wanted to take off a little bit of weight because I felt stuffed all the time. Now, granted, a girl do need to get back out there and work on her weight too, Sylvia, because I ain't no size 6, nor would I ever want to be a size 6 or a size 10. You know, I'm a size 12 to 14, and depending on what store we go to, I try to stay away from those junior sizes because they just run small in general. But I know how it feels when you go into a store and they don't carry your size. And I know how you feel, not just because of myself, but also because of my daughter, who's 13. So she has the same issues. And she says that a lot. And not even on in store in person. A lot of these little rinky dink online shops, same thing. They don't cater to voluptuous, curvy women. You know what I'm saying? And honestly, for me to say, yeah, girl, go ahead and get a butt change or a stomach reduction, that would be me lying. Or maybe even being maybe a hypocrite. Now, if you would have asked me over 2 years ago, April, you want to get a stomach reduction? Because I hate my stomach. I would have been all for it. Girl, yes, I'm in there. But after going through surgery for a full hysterectomy, you know, they had to cut me open right there in my stomach area. That was the worst pain that I've ever felt. And I had to deal with that for months and months, that pain. And once I went through that, I said to myself, I don't want to have any type of surgery ever in life. If I can't be happy with who I am, then I'm going to have to just work on my attitude and my weight. And I'm going to say this. Yeah, I got a fupa too. I got a fupa. I got fupas. Okay, whatever you want to call it. I got a fupa too. And I feel like sometimes to this day, I'm not even going to sit here and lie, I still am very self-conscious about it. And sometimes I do feel like, is my weight deteriorating? Is it deterring me from finding love or happiness? But then you have to stop and think, girl, and I said this to my daughters, if a person only look at you because of what you are on the outside, meaning skinny, thick, then they're not really into you. They only into what you look like on the outside. And you could be a whole nasty, mean bitch on the inside and be just as pretty on the outside. You understand what I'm saying? And like I said, the reason why they make different sizes in clothing and shoes is because we all are different sizes. You know, and even though this has nothing to do with weight, but I would feel that way about my feet. People look at me and they think that I'm making up a lie saying I wear a size 11 because I'm only 5'5". And if I go somewhere else, it'll say 5'3". So I don't really know what the hell I am. But I know that I'm just like an average height. But I wear a size 11 in shoes. You can't walk into just any store and find a size 11. Especially if you want to get into like a Target. I'm good at Target. But let's just say I wanted to go to one of those little boutiques. The biggest size they have is a 10, and my heels are going over those. My heels, the back of my foot heel is going to hang over the shoe. So why even put myself into something that's that small? So I understand what you mean about it. But the first thing that I really feel like, Sylvia, you really need to do is to learn to love yourself for who you are. Straight up. Once you learn to love yourself for who you are and what you have to offer, then that's all that matters. Then that Mr. Right will come along. And he may not even be Mr. Right. He might can be made into Mr. Right, because you don't never know. You never know when you first meet someone, is he Mr. Right? You don't know this. He could be Mr. Right, but he just can be downplaying because he don't want to be used, you know, shit like that. But I just feel like we all have to accept us ourselves for who we are and what we have to offer, you know, what we can bring to the table. Now, for one, your girlfriends, they might be having all these men, they might be in different relationships, but how long has their relationship lasted? Because from what I'm reading, you said they're always in a relationship, or they always they always have a relationship. Is it the same people? Because if it ain't, then let's just think about that. And here's another thing. Just because they're your friends, you are on the outside looking in. The grass is always greener on the outside. You don't know what this particular person could be going through in life. Just because they're smaller doesn't mean that they're happy. You know what I mean? Me, listen, I've tried diets, and I like to eat. I don't eat all the time because I'm just so busy. But who don't like a good burger? Who don't like a good meal? Okay, some collard greens, oxtails, and stuff like that. Why would I want to deprive myself from eating something good just to be a size 8, or just to look like the next person on social media, or the next person next door? Like, come on. The bottom line is you have to be yourself, be who you are. You know, sometimes I think to myself, like, well, maybe if I change it up a little bit, like dress a little bit different and wear makeup all the time, maybe I find me a nice looking man that's into me. But then I start thinking to myself, just like I said to my kids, this is me. I love to wear t-shirts, and I don't like wearing makeup every day. And if a man can't accept me for who I am, then I'm not going to sit around and pretend to be somebody else just to make you happy and just to make you love me. Then that means that you really don't give two fucks about me. And you're not really into me for the person that I am. You know, you always into what I look like. And with those type of relationships, girl, why even waste your money getting surgery? If a man's going to look at you because you got a nice big booty or a flat stomach, honey, you might want to run from those types. You might just want to run from that particular type of man, because he's very superficial, he's very materialistic, and on top of that, who wants to be bothered with anybody competing with other women? You have to learn to love you and yourself first. Fuck how your friends look. That's them. That's their metabolism. You are who you are, and ain't nothing wrong with a nice, thick girl and a little cushion for the pushing baby, okay? That's straight up. But the main thing is you have to learn to love yourself. Now, the other question she asked was, how does a person cope with being overweight and happy with themselves? I just want to know, is it me who gets tired of seeing this, meaning on social media? I don't know about you guys, but quite frankly, the social media shit, it used to bother me like years ago, But now I just look at them like, okay, that's you. If you want to pay for money to get yourself done, then hey, that's on you. That's your business. I could care less. Because at the end of the day, I don't really know what you're going through over there where you're at. I don't know if that big booty got you a good man. I don't know if that big booty get you money, extra money. I don't know if that big booty get you happiness. I don't know what that big booty or that flat stomach get you. I don't know. You know what I'm saying? Like when I look at social media, I scroll and I don't really pay no mind. But in person, the only reason why I get tired of seeing it in person out here, like when I moved out here to Arizona, let me tell y'all, I'm from New York, born and raised in Queens, New York City, and then moved upstate to live upstate New York in this little small town called Schenectady, next to Albany, New York. Now in Schenectady, New York, it's depressing. There's nothing there. It's dark. It's gloomy. There's really not any opportunities there. And that's the main reason why I left. There's nothing there. It's always dark and gloomy. It's always cold. There's probably like 2 or 3 months of warm weather, and that's in the summertime. And once October hits or the end of September, girl, forget about it. But there's no opportunities there. So that's the main reason why I moved here, you know? And I've never in my life seen so many people with fake butts ever in my life. You know, you watch it on TV, but in person, it's a total different. Now, when I say many different people, so many people, I mean from any age group. I've seen older women have butts done, lips done, tits done. And I know that these women have had this work done. They like 60 and 70 years old with big, big ass booties and big titties. Okay. And I don't care if you get your ass done, you know, it's a lot of bad ones. You know, you can always look at one and tell like, oh my God, especially when the legs are like this size, if you got a toothpick leg and your ass is like huge, big booty Judy, huge, like three big booty Judys, then girl, we already know. And it's a lot. It's a lot. And it's a lot of them out here. Like you'd be amazed. And I'm pretty sure that I have subscribers that are watching that live in Arizona and can relate. Like you do see a lot of women out here with big fake booties, and because they're not done properly, they're too annoying. They're just too huge. You know what I'm saying? And this is my thing. It's nothing wrong with getting any type of surgery if that's what you feel you want to do to make yourself feel better as a person. But don't do that shit for nobody else but you. You know what I'm saying? Because you also have to realize that that's maintenance, honey. I did not know that once you get any type of work done, like boobs or a butt, you have to maintain that. Like after a few years, like I think one of my friends, she had her boobs done 3 times. And it was my friend that used to live across the street from me, Angelique. And she was a porn star. She was a porn star. And she's my age now, so she doesn't do porn anymore. But I never knew that once you get fake boobs, you have to keep getting them, like, maintenance, like, every 10 years or something. If you don't, they'll start leaking or whatever. So I'm like, damn, what if you don't have the money to maintain that big, fat booty or those big boobs? Like, what do you do? What do you do? And, like, I'm sorry, but I don't think I want to be stuck out there where I don't have the money to maintenance these boobs or this ass that I done purchased. You know what I'm saying? I gotta save up or I gotta put it on layaway. Like, I'm not with all of that. You know what I'm saying? I'm just not with all of that. I need something that's a lifetime, like, for real. I'm not about to maintenance it like I get oil changes or anything like that. I really feel like if you want to enhance your beauty, do it because of yourself. Do it for yourself. That means you love yourself enough to do it for yourself. Don't do it because, if I lose this weight and I go get a stomach reduction, I'm gonna get a man. Honey, if a man only wants you because of how your body looks, he is not worth your time. And your worth is worth more than that. Straight up. Like, for real. Now, Sylvia, if you want to lose weight, do it because you want to lose weight. Not because your little thin friends are smaller. Okay? And there's nothing wrong with being thin neither, girl. You are who you are. Point blank, period. You are who you are. God made every last one of us different. If that was the case, then there'd be one particular size and nobody would need no diet pills, no diet, no exercise, no surgeries. He would make us all the same size and we would all look the hell alike. Wouldn't nobody have a problem finding a man or a relationship or anything like that. So when you do something, you do it for the count of what you want to do for you. Like I said, in the beginning, I wanted to lose weight. I lost the weight because I wanted to look good for a particular person and lose the weight. But then I started feeling like, April, if you don't get out this bed because your knees is hurting, what do you want to ride around on a scooter? Get out the bed and exercise. And you know something? I got up and I walked every day. I walked 2 miles every day. I exercised and I felt good. I lost the weight. Sometimes I thought I lost too much weight because my butt got really small, okay? And so nobody want to lose their big booty, honey. And not even because I want somebody looking at it, but I just like the way it look on me and fill out my clothes, okay? But once I started exercising, my legs felt better. I was able to bounce up and down them stairs like no problem. I felt like a youth again. I felt like, you know what I'm saying? Like I was in my early teens running up down them steps. Girl, listen. Before the exercise, I'd be huffing and puffing up them steps. Could you go get this for me upstairs? Could you get this for me upstairs? Because I would never want to go up the steps. Now, I'm able to get up the steps a whole lot better. Not saying today because I haven't exercised in a while. But, you know, I have started walking again, but I haven't been consistent like I used to. But I do this because I want to feel okay. It's a bitch when your legs hurt and you haven't even walked anywhere. Or when you out of breath and all you have done is walk up the steps, okay? And not to mention, when I lose the weight, you can see more of my little short neck because I don't really have much neck. So I have to lose the weight in order for me to look like I got a damn neck, all right? You know what I'm saying? So I do this because for health reasons. I don't care about looking like Megan, Sally, Tina, Farina, Bambina, Bambi, or whatever, whoever on Instagram or Snapchat or wherever. I don't care about looking like them. But there was a time when I felt like that. Like, you know what? I need a little tiny waist with my butt looking like this. This is how I would feel. And it's sad because society does portray like women with hourglass Coke figures are what we're supposed to look like. And it's not. When I say it's not, meaning we're all different. We're all unique. You can look like that. I can look like this. You can look like that. We're all different. You know what I'm saying? So not everything is for everybody. Straight up. Just because she did it doesn't mean that you need to do it. And girl, let me tell you, as for shopping with people that are smaller size, I get that. I get that. And you know what we do, me and Mumsy do, when we're with Nay at the mall and she wants to go into those little tiny stores that cater to little tiny, smaller people? We just walk off and we say, well, we're going to go in this store. Okay? That's what we do. We go in another store. We'll say, hey, we'll meet you over here because we're going to go look in here. I don't really want to walk around in a store either that caters to the biggest size is a large. I don't even got an extra large up in here. And when I say, I mean, I could fit some larges, okay? But some of those larges be more like a medium. It's like, a girl, you playing with a sister. This is not nobody's large. I can't even put my freaking knee up in here. So I try to stay away from stores like that. You know, I tell her, you know, we're going to go look in this store. We'll meet you over here. And she'd be like, okay, fine. So I understand that part. So sometimes we got to distance ourselves. I'm going to go, instead of standing around and waiting and looking at the little tiny things on the hangers, you just walk off and you go and look somewhere else. It don't even have to be another clothing store. Girl, it could be Bath & Body Works, candle shop, or wherever. You know what I'm saying? Something like that. But that's what we did yesterday. We walked off. And the crazy thing about it was we had a great time in the mall yesterday, and Forever 21 is in this mall. So at first, let me tell y'all, many, many, many years ago, many years ago, I want to say like 15 years ago when I had lost weight right after I had Mumsy. So yeah, it wasn't 15 years ago. You know, prior to that, I used to go to Forever 21 with my daughter Tati. And Forever 21 didn't have plus size at that time. You know what I'm saying? And it wasn't even called plus. It was called Forever Faith or something else it was called when it first came out. But when I used to go with my daughter Tati, she was like 16, 15. She was like about 14, 15. They didn't cater to plus sizes. The biggest size they had was a large. And I wasn't fitting into that. So I started losing weight. I started exercising and I started losing weight. And girl, let me tell y'all, when I finally lost so much weight, I was able to fit into Forever 21 clothes. I was so happy, so freaking happy. And then later on down the road, maybe like 2 years later, they came out with the plus size. It was called Forever Faith or Faith Forever 20, some shit like that it was called when it first came out. Trust me when I tell you, I still have some of the clothing from that long ago. That's how bad I don't never throw anything out. But yesterday when we was at the mall, we went into Forever 21. It's called, you know, Forever 21 with a plus sign. And I was like, Mumsy, look, let's go check out. Whenever we go into a clothing store and we'll see that there's plus for me and Mumsy, we'll go. Especially those little rinky-dink small shops. You know, some of their regular size clothing is not even regular size. And that was a really great experience. Mumsy came out with a bunch of clothes. And I came out with a t-shirt because, you know, I love t-shirts. They had some really nice things and the prices are right. So, Sylvia, check stores that cater to our size. I'm not even going to say your size. I'm going to say our size because I'm right there with you, girl. Okay. And as far as, you know, getting surgery to make yourself happy, why don't you start with some self-love? Okay. That'll save you a lot of money. Some self-love and just get out there and exercise a little bit. I'm not saying you got to go hard at it because I'm not one of those hard exercising people who like to live at the gym. No, that's not me, girl. But what I would say is, won't you start off with some self-love? If you're happy with your size, honey, then embrace that. Because ain't nobody going to love you like yourself. And ain't nobody going to accept you more but yourself. You know what I'm saying? And sometimes you don't even realize it, but you carrying weight around that you don't even realize. And when I say weight, I'm not talking about your fupa, your hips, your thighs. I'm talking about the burden that you carrying on your shoulder of being the size you are. That's extra weight. And sometimes people can see that all over your face, your vibe, your feng shui, your aura. They can see and feel that. You know what I'm saying? Sometimes we have like this resting bitch face where people can tell that you're unhappy. And that might be reason why you're not being approached. But here's the thing, sweetheart. Just because your friends have men, don't feel like you need to have one because they have one. Straight up. Don't ever feel like because somebody else got something that you gotta have it. Because it don't work like that in real life. The right person, you know the saying, is gonna come along when they come along. And that's a true fact. Straight up, that's a true fact. You know what I'm saying? When you learn to love yourself more and you know your worth, trust me, you're not gonna get none of these shindig Negroes or shindig men that just want you for one thing or a couple of things or money, cootie cat, a place to stay, a bum ass nigga. You're not gonna find none of those. When you learn to love yourself enough and you know your worth, girl, you gonna have men that are gonna approach you who gonna love who you are. There are many men out there that love a big girl, a thick girl, a nice size girl, a plus size girl. Just because you ain't thin like the rest of them don't mean that you can't have happiness and don't mean that you can't have a relationship, okay? You got to start off with loving yourself and loving who you are. You know what I'm saying? You have to appreciate what God gave you and who you are. Me personally, like I said, I complain still to this day about my stomach. And I complain about it on a daily basis to myself. Not on a daily basis. I'm exaggerating. But sometimes I complain about my fupa to myself. You know, out of 7 days out of the week, I'm going to say at least 4, all right? And I have finally come to the terms with, girl, this is you. And if nobody don't love you for you, then they not even worth your time, straight up. If they can't love you or like you, let's start off with like. If they can't like you, because like is the lowest, If they can't like you for who you are, then girl, they're not even worth your time. They're not even worth bringing up in a conversation. They're not even worth thinking about. They're not even worth getting a number. They're not even worth looking at. They're not worth your time. You know what I'm saying? We all different. Everybody different. Relationships sometimes are very overrated. Like, straight up, they are very overrated. Like, listen, it ain't nothing to be happy. You got to be happy first within before you be in a relationship with anybody. Okay? And you can always find love, but first you got to find love within yourself. And like I said, sometimes relationships are overrated. And I'm not saying this because I'm not in one. Because who wouldn't want to be in a loving relationship with someone who appreciates you, who ain't lying, who ain't conniving, who ain't a user? Who wouldn't want to be in a relationship like that with a perfect person? And nobody's perfect. But when I say perfect person, perfect in your eyes, even with their flaws, they're still perfect to you. You know what I'm saying? But sometimes a relationship can be overrated because a lot of people feel like I've noticed that they look at relationships on social media, goals, relationship goals, and you think like their relationship is so perfect. You on the outside looking in. That's your relationship goals. You don't even know these people, but this is your relationship goals. Okay. How about you have a goal for yourself? Fuck a relationship goal. That's what I'm saying. When relationships be overrated sometimes, because people always looking on the outside, looking in. You don't even know what could be going on in their house. Just because if they look happy to you, that don't mean that they happy. They could be the most miserable ass thin people in the world. Because you feel like they're happy, that's your relationship goals. That's why I be talking about relationships are so overrated. Because you don't know what another person goes through. You understand what I'm saying? You sometimes you invest so much in a person that you don't even invest it in yourself. And then you lose all motivation for yourself because you're so busy worrying about what that person you in a relationship think about you. You have to, one, know who you are first. Accept yourself for your flaws and your non-flaws. Accept yourself for who you are. Size 18, size 8, who gives a shit? Regardless, at the end of the day, you're going to wake up being Sylvia and you're going to go to sleep being Sylvia. And regardless of how you feel, Sylvia, or what you plan to do, you know what I'm saying? If you still feel like going through with the surgery, that's on you. But just do it for you and don't do it because you're trying to find a man, okay? But at the end of the day, just realize that, you know what I'm saying? We all made different. We all made unique. I'm sorry, but I don't want to look like the next person no more. I don't. I used to, but I don't no more. And I just feel like this. If you don't like me for who I am, then boy, bye. Okay? I could care less. So you want me to sit around and look thin all the time and look like I've been working out 7 days a week for like 2-3 hours a day and my face is always flawless with makeup on? Dude, when I go to sleep, you're going to wake up next to somebody that looks just like this. All right? Just like this. Love yourself for who you are first, honey. Don't worry about what your friends got going on. Because just because they're your friends don't mean that they tell you everything. You don't really know. Some people don't like to divulge a whole lot of information, and that's fine. There's nothing wrong with that. But just because they're your friends, don't think that you know everything about them. Because you don't. And just because they could wear that size 8, sweetheart, don't mean that they don't make it in a size 18. You just gotta look somewhere else, sweetie. When your time is right, your time is right, and it's gonna come. Try to avoid the ones that be like, yo, what's up, ma? Try to avoid those, because I get those ones a lot, too. What's up, ma? And you know what I do when a man or a ninja be like, yo, what's up, ma? I be like, I don't know you. I don't remember giving birth to you. I ain't your mother. That's what I say, because I'm not your mother, and you're not about to approach me with, hey, ma, what's up? Boy, bye, okay? That right there alone lets me know that you ain't got no respect. And if you want to approach me with, hey, ma, then trust and believe you're going to be approaching my back. You're going to be looking at my back, walk away from you. My backside, my back, the back of my head. You're going to see me, hey, ma, you must be looking for your mother. She over there because it ain't me. So when your time is right, the right one will approach you. Or he might not even approach you. You know, sometimes in this day and age, they don't even approach. You know what I'm saying? And I'm not even interested in approaching, to be honest with you. I'd rather work. For right now, I'm working on myself, my home, and my family. I don't care less about anything else. But what I'm telling you, Sylvia, is work on your self-esteem. work on you, girl. Work on you. And I'll tell you, once you love you and you love the skin that you are in, honey, ain't no stopping you. For real. I love to see any woman of any size confident within themselves. And that's the main thing. Be confident, sweetheart. Fuck your friends. And when I say fuck your friends, I don't mean like, oh, meaning don't worry about what they got going on. Don't worry about what size clothes they wear. Girl, worry about Sylvia. And don't be in such a rush to get into a relationship and do things out of bounds to get a relationship. Hope you guys can relate. Leave some information, leave some opinions, leave some thoughts down below for Sylvia. So I love you all. You know what I'm saying? Leave your comments below and share the video. And I will see y'all in the next one. And yeah, make sure you rate, comment, subscribe. Deuces.